Good day, fam. This is Ton. Today I'll be installing this set of PS Superior Bass horns into my 2021 Toyota Highlander. You got an SUV, and if you're going to have an SUV, I think it's only appropriate to have a horn that is deep and throaty. For some people, they're okay with the stock factory horns on the Highlander. It's okay. However, I wanted to get something a little bit more throatier and deep in bass. That would mean that there's going to be more vibration, especially in a hybrid that I have, in case I need to honk at somebody because my hybrid's too quiet, or somebody's tailgating, or you know, whatever reasons why you end up honking at people. Go ahead, test it out. Honk your own horn. If you're satisfied with the horn, then this mod is not for you. But if you honk your horn and it sounds like a high pitch, and you want to do something about it, then keep on watching and watch me install this into my car. So some things that you're going to need, I'll put all the links of these products in the description for the PIAA horns, and also for this horn speaker adapter that you'll need for Toyotas. So you'll need that 12 millimeter wrench, needle nose pliers to crimp, a lighter, so that way you can use these shrink tube, right? You'll need some shrink tube, and then it'll come in handy if you have this little pry tool right here. So let's go ahead and quickly open up this box. Let me show you what's inside. So in the Highlander, there's already two horns, and so this set comes with two horns as well. One is at 330 Hz and the other one is at 400 Hz. Basically, you can hear the difference when you hear the two horns go off. Here's what you get inside. All right, you got the two horns right here. And you're gonna have your power terminals right there. Looks like you got some instructions in here. And then you have some ground cables in here. So let's get to work, y'all. All right, so I took everything out of the bag. These are the wires from the car horn adapter. These are the ground cables. You get two of them that came with the PIAA package. And so the first thing we're gonna do is hook these up right here. So these will plug right into the Toyota harness. That's why you get these adapters, so that way you don't have to splice any wires. And so let's go ahead and take this off. Take one of these shrink tubes. Stick it in there. Crimp that good. Just overlay the shrink. Got it all the way over there. Stick the lighter. All right. Watertight. Cool it down. Repeat the process for the second power cable. When it's going to go for each of the horns. All right, so we got the two power cables connected. And so we got the grounds from the package. So on each of the horns, we're going to have two terminals. The directions say that the power cable should be to the top terminal. So we'll just take that, plug it right in. There we go. And then the ground, this is the ground, will go on the bottom one. All this is plug and play, y'all. There we go. So, one set done. This is for the 330Hz. That's the lower bass one. And then we're gonna do this power on the top. Ground on the bottom. All right. So now, the next step is to remove the factory horns and install these bad boys. So let's go ahead and do that next. All right. So what you'll do next is you're gonna remove these grommets here. I think there's 9 of them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So they're easy because you just push them in, push them all in. You ever go to McDonald's and when you order a fast food drink, on the top of the cup you have those buttons to push? This is what it reminds me of. Alright, because what you want to do is you want to remove this cover off right here, so that way you can actually get access to the horns, so you can get those removed. Alright, once you got those 9 grommets out, keep them in a safe place. You can just lift this off. Let's put it over here for now. I'm going to put that back on later. And then you're going to get exposed to the horns right here. Let's see if I can give you a better good shot right here. So the horn number 1 right here, and horn number 2 is right here. And if you're curious where that sound comes from when you put the car in reverse, if you have a hybrid, it's this speaker right here. So it's an actual electronic speaker that makes that angel sound when you put the car in reverse for hybrid owners. So we're going to take these out. And you're going to use a 12 millimeter wrench to remove the bolt right here. Now before you take it off, this would be a good time to disconnect the power right here. Plug it out right here. And then you can do the same on this end right here. There we go, got that plugged out as well. And let's go ahead and screw this out. Alright, so here is the stock OEM horn on the left side, made by Denso. So we're going to take that out, and then we're going to take the PIAA horn. I'm going to put the 330 on the left side. Just use the same bolt, stick it right up in there. And just hand tighten it for now. The reason why I'm hand tightening it is that's where I'm going to put the ground cable right before I tighten it up with the wrench. So remember, there's 2 cords, right? Cables here. This is the power. This is the ground. This ground is just going to go right behind where the bolt is, so that way it's touching bare metal. And that's where I'm going to do it for both left and right side. And then for the power adapter, the car, plug those in, you should be good to go. All right, so let's go ahead and do the right side.
tight at first. There we go. Yeah, so I don't believe that these are going to be any louder than the stock ones, maybe just by a little, but I decided to get these more because I wanted to the deeper tone, the deeper bass for the vibration. All right, bye bye. How you doing? Right into that bolt there. Again, stand tight. Right before you cinch it in, stick the ground cable in there so it's touching some bare metal for the ground. All right, so before we put the cover back on and close the hood, one thing I will do is just give the wiring some more protection and kind of give it a more clean look. I don't like the wires being exposed. I'll put a link for this in the video description, but I also bought some quarter inch split wire looming, cut it to size so that way it has a split down here. And what we're going to do is we're going to cover up these wires so we can give it a more clean look. I already did this side right here, so you can tell right here, covered that wiring up, covered the other wiring up so it blends in with the other OEM covers down there. Just makes it a nice clean look as opposed to just having the wires exposed like this. That's what it looks like through the grill. Then all that's left to do is put this cover back on and put those 9 grommets back on and you're good to go. But before I do that, I got some bonus footage for you. I'm gonna be installing a Toyota Heritage badge that I've had for a few months now. So I'm gonna install this somewhere right over here. And so since this cover is off, this is a perfect time to go ahead and put that bad boy in. All right, here's your bonus footage. This is the Toyota Heritage badge that I'll be putting in the front of my grill. And I'm going with this color just because it kind of, you know, matches with the Blizzard pearl white of my car anyways. So I'm gonna put some Loctite blue just to make sure those threads are properly secured. And here's the bag of bolts that it comes with here. All right, so got the bolt threaded on there. You guys, you see that blue Loctite there? Takes about 10 minutes to dry and then 24 hours to cure. And I found a spot where I think would be looks perfect in the grill that would actually lay flush with the grill and not stick out. So basically I'm gonna stick it in there and then I'm going to put this plastic thing over, and then there's some washers and bolts that you put over, and then just screw tight it in.
So here's the spot I'm talking about.
It's this hole right here, y'all. And if you can see, this perfect hole right here. So when I stick it in, look at that. It just lays flush. I'll go ahead and put this on the inside and then screw the washer and the bolt into place.
What do you think? I likes that right there, my friends. Just gave me an extra 5 horsepower, baby. And here's what I'm talking about, how it looks flush. So it looks more flush right there. It just blends right into the grill right there. Yeah. And then what it looks like on the inside, you can see it right there. The two bolts. Tighten that up real good. Makes it a lot easier when you take this cover off to be able to get access right into here. And that is it, my friends. Just take this, reverse the process, lay this back on. Put the 9 grommets back in, call it a day. So with these grommets, because you push them in, you gotta pop them back out. Just push it back from that top, and that might help to just kind of bend these back in. But once you get able to push them back in, they should just pop right into place. Alright fam, so final thoughts on the horn mod. This is probably something I may not do if I could reverse time. From the test and just from my ear test, didn't sound like the PIAA horns were any louder than the stock ones. However, I can definitely tell that it has a lower bass tone. I can even feel the vibration compared to the stock horns. So I guess that's the only plus I would give it, just considering the time put into doing this mod. Like I said, I probably wouldn't do it again. I think maybe what I probably will do if I feel like it is I might take out these horns and actually put them into my wife's Camry, because my wife's Camry does sound like the Roadrunner bird. So I hate that high-pitched sound, so I might switch it over there or just leave it the way it is. So again, thanks for watching, and hit the like button, subscribe. I got some pretty cool videos coming up. One of them is applying the Laminex film cover to the headlight, and I'll also attempt to do a smoke out of the amber reflector right here. Again, that's just some of the things that I have on my mind. I also have a mod video where I'm going to replace this hood strut, and I'll be putting in gas powered ones. So thanks again. Peace.